Hi there, from the Texas Instruments Voltage Supervisors product line. We present our series of short videos called Voltage Supervisors 101. For the third video of our Voltage Supervisors 101 series, we are going to cover in detail the input specifications of a voltage supervisor. Specifications for a voltage supervisor can be divided up into three main categories: input, output, and timing features. For this video, we will go into details on the input, which include topics such as input threshold, tolerance, hysteresis, power on reset, and manual reset. Voltage at the input of the supervisor, shown here as Vsense, is resistor divided down from the monitored voltage called Vmon. To avoid the supervisor from asserting a reset, the voltage level on Vsense must stay above the negative going input threshold voltage called Vit minus, which can be found in the electrical characteristics table of the datasheet. In the example above, Vsense will need to stay above 400 millivolts or 403 millivolts, accounting for tolerance, or the device will assert a reset. Similar to how Vsense needs to stay above Vit minus, Vmon will need to stay above a certain threshold voltage called Vmon UV to avoid the supervisor from asserting a reset. This undervoltage threshold for the monitored voltage is dependent on the system's requirement or what minimum voltage level is needed on the voltage rail for the system to function correctly. The user would select Vmon UV based off the system requirements and then use the following equation to calculate what sense resistors are needed to achieve that value. To summarize, let's say the system is monitoring a 3.3 volt voltage rail, and the system needs to assert a reset when that rail is at or below 2.93 volts. With the appropriately specified resistor ladder, under proper operating conditions, Vsense will be at 450 millivolts. In the case Vmon dips to 2.93 volts, or equivalently, Vsense dips to the Vit minus of 400 millivolts, the supervisor will assert a reset. The supervisor that has been featured thus far in this video includes the flexibility for the user to manipulate two external resistors to set the appropriate Vmon UV voltage level. We call these devices supervisors with an adjustable voltage threshold, or adjustable VTH, and are generally used for systems that have unique, specific targeted voltage thresholds. They can also be utilized if a system has multiple voltage rails of different values. This way, the user can use multiple units of the same voltage supervisor, assign each with its own unique resistor ladder, meeting their supervising requirements and simplifying their BOM with one part number to keep track of. There is another class of devices that generate its monitored voltage off of the input voltage VDD and utilize internally trimmed resistors. We call these devices supervisors with a fixed voltage threshold, or fixed VTH. For simplicity, in the datasheet of fixed voltage threshold supervisors, Vmon UV is directly referred to as Vit minus, as shown in the example above. These supervisors will come with popular predetermined voltage threshold options to suit the system requirements. These supervisors are generally utilized if the user has one specific voltage rail that needs to be monitored. Without the need of external sense ladder, the user can then save on the cost of resistors as well as reduce the number of discrete components on the board itself. As mentioned earlier in the video, the negative going voltage threshold, Vit minus, has a voltage tolerance which directly affects Vmon UV. This is due to temperature drift within the internal voltage reference. Moreover, the external resistors on an adjustable voltage supervisor or the internal resistors on a fixed voltage supervisor also have inherent tolerances. Together, they will yield a total tolerance and need to be accounted for in the system's design. For example, take the TLV-803S in the figure shown above. Vmon UV, referred to directly as Vit minus, is set to 2.93 volts nominally. However, looking at the datasheet, if tolerances are accounted for, the threshold voltage may deviate from 2.87 volts to 2.99 volts, which would cause the reset to assert earlier or later. This particular device then has a tolerance of plus or minus 2% across the full operating temperature range. If tighter voltage tolerances are needed, Voltage supervisors that have more complex designs could yield better tolerances, some as good as plus or minus 0.9%. Another input specification to consider is the stability of the monitored input voltage. Given an event where Vmon is rising but begins to oscillate around the threshold voltage, Vmon UV, the output of the supervisor will also oscillate, potentially leading to system instability. To counteract this effect and ensure that the voltage rail is stable, an additional amount of voltage, called hysteresis voltage, VHYS or VHIS, is added to the negative going threshold voltage. Specifically, if the output of a voltage supervisor were to fall and cross Vmon UV, the output must then rise above Vmon UV plus Vhysteresis to deassert the reset output. In this example, looking at the TLV-803S, the negative going threshold voltage is 2.93 volts nominal. To get the supervisor to deassert the reset, the voltage rail will have to go past 2.93 volts plus a hysteresis voltage of 40 millivolts as specified in the parametric table. This total voltage to deassert the reset will be 2.97 volts and is also called the positive going threshold voltage. Our final input specification to consider is the power on reset voltage. When the supervisor first powers up and VDD begins rising from 0 volts, the supervisor output will be at an undefined state. This is because the internal output MOSFET is off, and the supervisor has no way to control the internal circuitry that's pulling the output low. As a result, the output could exhibit a small amount of voltage, where ideally it should have no voltage potential. The voltage level up to which this effect can be observed is called the power on reset voltage, or VPOR. The specifications of VPOR is defined in the parametric table of the datasheet as shown. In the example above, when VDD begins rising, the output of the supervisor is in an undefined state. Once VDD surpasses the VPOR of 1.1 volts, the internal output MOSFET will turn on and properly pull the output low. To conclude, some voltage supervisors also include a feature called manual reset, or MR. MR allows a user to force a reset assertion at the output of the supervisor regardless of the monitored voltage. As an example, when Vmon is above the positive going input threshold voltage and the manual reset is asserted, the manual reset takes precedence and the supervisor will assert a reset. The MR can be connected to a push button and pressed whenever a user wishes for a reset to occur, irrespective of what is happening within the system. This feature is useful for any application where a hard reset may be needed to reset the system in the case the processor is in a brownout state and unresponsive. This concludes our video on the input specifications of the voltage supervisor. Texas Instruments has one of the widest breadth of products in its voltage supervisor portfolio. To learn more, please visit us at www.ti.com/supervisors. Where you can find supervisors with different features, read our tech notes and blogs, and use the TI ETE support page to ask any questions.